So, very early on, and it's written in our books, but for me, I was trained in a certain way, and I remember a case of a girl, she was about 3, who came to me, and she taught me a very important lesson, almost maybe 18 years ago, and she had tonsillitis and very painful abscesses. But what was happening was more interesting, and in a way at that time was even distracting, because what she was doing was, she didn't care of what I was asking the mother, but she just had a block of different pieces of puzzles of different shapes, and all she was interested was to see how she could put in those different shapes one after the other, and almost as if she was in her mind timing how quickly she could do this, you know. So she'd kind of do it, and then she'd dismantle it, and then she'd take a deep breath, and whew, again she'd go, and every time she was getting faster and faster and faster. And I said, I have been taught that what we see and what is characteristic is also, this is peculiar. So whatever remedy I give, it should cover this aspect also. But the remedies that I'm thinking of are not covering that. So I knew something is amiss, but what, I didn't know, because it was too premature. It was the beginnings of understanding of this whole concept to me and in my learning. So I decided to pay attention, and then the mother also realized that what she was saying was, didn't seem as important. So even she started to observe what the child was doing. And after this got over, and she felt as if she can't go any faster, she turned the thing into a flat surface, and she took all these shapes, and she started creating one after the other different designs and out of these shapes. And she'd look at it and she'd be pleased. Sometimes she wouldn't be. She'd dismantle it, make another design, and another design, and another design. And I said, the remedy has to have this as well. I sent them out because really I was perplexed. And I said, what do I do? Do I just give something which covers this and this? Something told me no. But then what do I do? So I said, okay, let me open up the repertory. So the way a homeopath works, I'll just show you a little glimpse. So we have this now in our software. It makes things little interesting for us. So what? It wasn't easy, but I was trying to see what is that? What is she doing? And I came across this rubric. See, this is a rubric, quick to act. And there are few remedies there. So there are about 7-8 remedies. And there is one remedy over there which I finally gave her, which is the COFF, which is coffee, or coffee. You just come from our tea and coffee break. So I came across this rubric. We can put this here. And then so she was doing a kind of an activity, and for me, this didn't come that easily then. I'm just telling you in a nutshell what happened, how this discovery came. And I said, she's doing something very creative. And I came exactly across this rubric, which is activity creative. So you put this here. There's something which was, obviously there was something on the computer which I may have been working on earlier. But the point is that when you check this rubric here, down there, activity creative, do you see? Again, there is coffee there as well. So what does one understand from that? One understands that I was in a dilemma. Do I choose coffea. Coffea is not known to be a remedy for tonsillitis. For pain, yes, it is known for pain, but for abscesses, no. This kind of pussy abscesses, not in my understanding. But the general became more important than the particular. That is what we are trying to see when we are trying to approach an issue. What becomes more important is what is the grand generalization, mental and physical. And I said, it has to be a remedy which the main general issue is to be quick, excitable, deliver and creative concepts. And it needed a little bit more confirmation to know that in every area. She is quick. Mother just has to say, we are going for a picnic. She has got her picnic bag ready. Okay, I am ready, mom. That kind of excitement. I want you to see this picture. We will come back to this slide again. If you can look at it, after the coffee, what has happened is, you can see how she is projecting and the ideas. Is it difficult to understand why the coffee machine is present, especially in advertising agencies? Because that's what the coffee does. So the main general sensation of coffee is stimulant. So the personality type of someone who needs coffee or coffee is easy stimulation. So her mind has gone into almost horses galloping. This kind of, if you see it carefully, the hair is actually in the end. The people in the behind, I don't know if they can appreciate or not, is actually the shape of horses. So for me, this picture was interesting. Just to convey to you how a stimulant mind and a general mind can present in a case of coffee. The girl finally got coffee. Within 2 days, the tonsillitis, the fever, the abscesses discharged.
This is more to do with the presentation you are given. I would like to understand the concept you have used. You gave the example of the 3-year-old girl whom you treated for tonsillitis and abscess. Now, in that you mentioned that her hyperactivity or her ability to figure the factors or something. I thought that was a positive because there was a positive energy.
Can everybody hear?
Yeah.
So then maybe the mic is not on. So that is important.
I am referring to the case of the 3-year-old girl that you mentioned. I would like to understand the concept you used for giving her coffee. Now, the girl had hyperactivity, as you mentioned. But I thought that was maybe the activity level of that particular child. It was not a negative, connotation. Then you should have normally treated only the abscess and the tonsillitis with those medicines. Then what made you give coffee? How does that help? Where is the concept?
Very good question. See, firstly you have to understand that we are trying to put in a nutshell something which requires years of understanding and practice. I am trying to understand what you all do, you all are trying to understand what I do, and in that we grow together, okay? Firstly, so I am breaking your questions into two parts, which is that a homeopathic remedy does not take away our passions or interests at all, no? And that is what we are and that is what we should be. That is what is special and unique about us, no? Same way, coming to the coffee girl, the quick activity, the stimulation, the creative activity, these are good things. You need people also, you know, who are quick-paced. But sometimes the quickness is to the point where it is detrimental to even allow us to slow down in life. It's the concept of that fisherman who is lying there and, you know, that person is telling you are wasting your time. You're, what are you doing, you know? Go something, he says, okay, then what, you know this, we all know this. And finally he says, then what? And he says, then you will have your own place and you will be lying down here, relaxing, and you know, he says, what do you think I'm doing right now? So, sometimes, when the pace is too much, we need to know when to slow down. When it's too slow and sluggish, we should know when we have to exercise a certain urgency in life. So, when I've said that case, I just mentioned it in 5 minutes, but the fact is the remedy as a remedy is very highly sensitive to pain. So, the threshold of pain is very, very acute in coffee. when I took this case and talked to the mother of the same child, I said, now it's your turn, tell me about the labor history. She said, firstly, I'm never going to have a second child. I said, why? She said, because of the pain. You know, that time was many years ago, so epidurals, etc. were not there. She said, I actually thought I will die. Now, it's the mother's remedy also, firstly. Because in the mother's remedy, there was urgency. She had to deliver things, creative design. She was a designer in time, and she knew once she gets close to 9 months, she'll not have the time. And once she's delivered, she'll not be able to give time to her designs. This was her pace. And as the labor came, she was screaming, she was shrieking. Now, when you check the rubrics, Joe bought an important thing. He said some of them may not know what are rubrics. So when I point out those things, those are rubrics. It's like words which you use, which you all also use sometimes, you know, corporate reinforcement or whatever. Those are the words which you all have. You know, as homeopaths, we also have, from the provings that have been done, the words are condensed. It's like a milk versus a condensed milk. You know, and that is taken in the form of a word which is a rubric. That is broken, it is pregnant with meaning. That is a rubric. So one of the rubrics of coffee and which it was chosen for her was, for example, she was not sitting down. Then it all started making sense. I said, why are you not sitting? So the mother is saying she cannot tolerate. Even if she sits a little, she will jump with pain. So the sensitivity to pain was a big issue. Besides the other two things which I mentioned earlier. Then there's also a small girl who's again like her mother, if you don't treat that, is going to progress into womanhood with the concept that pregnancy is horrible. It's a horrifying experience because during labor you can die. There is a rubric again in coffee which is fear of death during labor. So all this, now when you look at it that way, the positive things, did it change? Did she stop becoming a lively person? No. She remained what she was. Her cheerful disposition continued. But what reduced was her sensitivity to pain. Her imagination or her delusion that the pain is too much, I am going to die. She becomes a more productive and a relaxed mother in today's society. So that coffee hour which we thought was just treating her tonsillitis and her abscess, finally evolves her into being a more complete woman who can enjoy everything and people can enjoy her presence. Now you tell me, what is better, to treat an abscess or a tonsillitis or to create something which a remedy, if it is capable of creating a more holistic person for tomorrow? I am not in contact with these girls for years. She is obviously okay, but I am sure she will contact the clinic. But I know today what she is. The coffee hour for sure has played a role in making her what she is. So in that sense, the homeopath has personality types, but it doesn't modify anything in any way. If anything, it only enhances that further so that they can channelize those parts and use it more productively.